Hi, and welcome to Coding with Dennis. I'm Dennis. In this video here, we'll have a look at Torch Vision and how to make use of pre-trained deep learning models. We'll be working with the popular AlexNet, which is pre-trained on the ImageNet dataset, and then we'll try out how well it performs on our own images. So let's jump over to the notebook. So the major parts of this notebook here is from the Learn OpenCV blog post. So I encourage you to go over and have a look at that. That's a really good blog post. But for the complete notebook here, I'll put the link in the description so you can go ahead and run the notebook yourself. So at first, now we'll, beside importing Torch, also import Torch Vision. And from there, we will be looking at the models section, where we see that there's a lot of modules, models in there, AlexNet, DenseNet, GoogleNet, and so on. So one thing you should notice here is, for instance, AlexNet, it's mentioned both here in lowercase and here in with camel case. And the only difference is that AlexNet and the one AlexNet, that the capital one, camel case one, is a Python class, whereas AlexNet, the lowercase one, is a convenience function that returns a model instantiated from the AlexNet class. Now we can go ahead and, from models, we will be using AlexNet in this example here, and then you can pass in this pre-train equal true. What it will then do is go and download all the weights for the network pre-trained on ImageNet. So what we get here to begin with, or what we see here, is just the architecture of AlexNet. We see that the output is 1,000 features. So now what we want to do is try to use this AlexNet on a new image to do some classification. So to do this, let's just load in an image. So here is an image of a cat. And then we need to do some cropping and resizing for AlexNet. So AlexNet is set up in such a way that it takes images of 256 times 256. So here we just load in the image, and here we just show an example of how this resizing would look like. So this is in fact the image that will feed into the network and not this one up here. But this is not the way that the resizing is done. This is done through a transformer in Torch Vision. So with Torch Vision, there's these transformers composed of different kinds of transform. So in this case, can both have a resize to 256, which is what we want to resize our image to. Then after that resizing, how they also trained the original network was with a center crop of 224 pixels. So we will end up, in fact, with a 224 times 224 image. Then we'll convert it into the image into a tensor. And finally, they have some image normalization. So this here is just the values that were also used, or the values from the training set, which we'll then also use for inference. For infinite time of our network. So let's create this transformation, and now we can apply this transformation to our image. So we get our image transformed, and now we see that yes, it has been resized, and then we have the center crop 224 times 224. So this is in fact what we put into the network, and then we create a batch here. Prepare a batch for the network. Let's just evaluate AlexNet here and then input our image. And the output of AlexNet we put into the variable out here, and its shape, so this will be a tensor of size 1 times 1,000. So it will have a probability for each of the 1,000 classes in ImageNet. So how does these classes actually look like, and how can we then transform these numbers into a description of the actual class? So to do so, we have the description of all classes in ImageNet, which is here. So if we run this line here, then we'll just get a print of all the different classes in ImageNet. So yeah, English Foxhound, Italian Greyhound, and so on. And now we'll just go in and take the output, sort it descendingly, and print out the name as well here. And we're just taking the first 10 instances. And what we get is that for this image, we have the Persian cat. It classifies that as the most likely. So with 78% probability, and then it comes here in descending order. A tabby cat, a tiger cat, a hamper, remote control is 1.3%, and so on. So now let's go ahead and try with another image. So maybe a hamster. I thought this image here was quite funny, so at least for us, both we see a hamster, but beside that, then there's also signs saying this is a hamster. This is again the resize just for visualization purpose that we'll put into the network. And now you can just go ahead and execute all the following lines of code. We will then eventually get out that the most likely class is a Pomeranian. The second is a cup, Chihuahua, and a hamster is only is on the fifth place, so it's only 4% probability of being a hamster. So AlexNet is definitely not perfect, as you can see. And we just have one more image here, a centipede. And let's execute the remaining cells of this network here. And here it gets it correct that with 92% probability, this is a centipede. So now I encourage you to download this notebook and go ahead, try to load some of your own images and see how AlexNet or one of the other networks performs on this on your own images. So as I already mentioned, in the description of the video, you'll be able to find the link to the notebook. And so with that, we are in the end of the video. I hope you learned something, and I hope to see you back in the channel for another coding tutorial. But until then, thank you for watching.